Did you ever feel like, oh, if I just had more energy, I could get this done? Or you get up and you have to face some things and you think, ugh, not today. But I have found a source of energy that you are going to love. And you say, well, you're, how old are you? I'm 89 and I found this source a long time ago. I'm still using it. So what you're watching today, oh, is going to be a great blessing to you. I found two sources of energy. One of them I found is the Word of God. Now, if you look at the Greek, and I'm not a big Greek scholar, but I learned this, you know, and Sarah helped me with some of it. She is a big Greek scholar. But I learned that one of the words for energy is energeia, which means an active energy that you do. And so we find in different places in the New Testament, energeia. There's an energy, but I have found that it's in the Word. And so maybe I don't feel it, but I can take hold of the Word and use it as energy in my life. And you know, I can tell you, going overseas when you have jet lag, and you're due to speak at a big meeting, and you feel as spiritual as a mouse, and where is your memory? How do you spell Bible? And you depend on His energeia. And now, I found, again, two sources. So these are very important for you. One is the Word of God. So when I read the Word, and I like to read it early in the morning, I feel like I am putting an energy inside. Now, I not only read it, I speak it. And so I speak promises for the day. You say, well, do you feel spiritual? No, no, I don't. But it gives me energy. I am speaking what He says, and there's energy. Like if I said, I can do all things today through Christ who strengthens me. Now you could say, yeah, you're saying it, but does it work? Yes, because it is the Word. It is the energy of God's Word. So I'm very particular about this. I do it first thing. I fix coffee. Oh yeah, I like coffee. And then I speak almost 40 promises. And so I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Thanks be to God who makes me always triumph in Christ. You know, scriptures like that. You can pick out your list, but do it because it some way energizes me. It really, really does. But that's energeia. And you can find it. You can look it up in your Strong's Concordance and you can find wherever it occurs in the New Testament. But also, there's another word for energy that I have found is very interesting. And it's exousias. E-X-O-U-S-I-A-S, and it means authority. And so I can speak promises that give me authority in a situation. Again, I can use the same thing. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I have the authority to speak that, but I can speak. I am surrounded with favor like a shield. Now, you know, how do you get into Muslim countries? They hate women, you know, and they're not wild over Christians. But I began to speak a long time ago. I love Muslims and Muslims love me. And it took some process of time. And now my biggest meetings are in Muslim countries. And I have some opportunities, you know, when everything opens up again, to go into some of these countries. And more so because I'm old, because Muslims like old women. And I'm old, I fit it. So I am speaking that I have favor in these countries that I feel God will have me go to. And I'm speaking energy to have the energy to do it. And so when you start speaking promises, they have energy, but also they have authority. So if the enemy says, well, you can't do it, it's not going to work. You can say, wait a minute, The Bible says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Maybe you have some health problems. Speak to your health problems and speak the promises of God. You know that he heals us and delivers us from every destruction. So I'm going to share something that happened to me a long time ago. I had a back problem, and I'd go to bed at night and go to sleep, but then I'd wake up in the night and, oh, my back would hurt. So I'd have to get out of bed, get on the floor, lie flat, and then in the morning when I got up, I would be bent over until almost lunchtime because I had that pain. So my husband said to me, I'm going to pray for you. We're just going to pray and believe God that you don't have that, whatever it is with your spine. So we prayed. It didn't happen right away. And for 6 months, I got up every morning and I would be bent over like this. And I would speak what God said, that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. You know, that he sent his word and healed me and delivered me from every destruction. Now, it didn't look like it. And I remember that time, that was a long time ago, I was teaching a Bible study and I was teaching them about healing and I would come in bent over like this. Now, I'm sure they thought, oh, brother, if it works for you, I don't want it for me. But I stuck with it. Now, you know, I never have a back problem and I fly on planes and all kinds of things, you know. And I don't have a back problem, but it took 6 months of speaking it and believing it. And so how do we release energy? Remember, we do it by speaking what he says, but also we do it by praying in the Spirit. I'm very strong on this, that praying in the Spirit releases energy. So, you know, when I'm going to church, you know, or I'm driving someplace, or I'm on a plane even, I do it. I'm not obnoxious, but I pray in tongues. And you say, well, I don't think it works. Don't tell me that. It's too late. I've been doing this for years, praying in the Spirit. And I'm telling you, I've seen God give me favor in Muslim countries, in Hindu countries, in atheist places, that, you know, people would listen to me and I would have healing miracles in those places. So I believe we have two sources of energy. We have the word, exousios, that's authority, and we have the Spirit, which is energy. And those two, energeia and exousios, man, they work and they work beautifully and they'll work for you. So I'm so happy you watched this today, but I want to share something else with you. I have a little booklet, What to Do in a Crisis by Sarah. And you can get on our website and get this. I know you'll like it. She's a woman of faith, a woman of anointing, a woman of wisdom. She's awesome, and I'm not prejudiced. I know you say, oh, yes, you are. Yes, I'm very prejudiced, but you will love the book and booklet, and it's free. Everybody say free. Free, you can have it free. And I want you to practice speaking the word, the promises every day. I want you to practice praying in the Spirit. You know, you can do it in the bathtub, you can do it in the car. There are just so many places that you can do it, and you don't waste time, and you're not just, oh, well, what's going to happen, blah, blah, blah. Just shut up. Turn your brain off on that. Turn it on to the Spirit and turn it on to the Word. And I love having this time with you.